right. So let's go to Psalm. I'm going to read the Bible from the book of Psalm, chapter number 90, from verse number 12. Psalm 90 from verse number 12. Are you there?
Yes.
All right. I know we have different versions, so I want to hear the NIV. Who has the NIV? Yes. Who has the King James? Mr. Philip. Who has another translation? You read us the Message Bible from your phone. Yes, Sammy?
Yes.
ESV. All right. So let's begin with what? Let me read the New King James Version, and then we read the other versions. Are you ready?
Yes.
Mumechangamka?
Yes.
All right. So one, two, go. Let me read for you. So teach us to number our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Teach us to number our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. All right. So Ken, read for us.
Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain a heart of wisdom.
That we may gain a heart of wisdom. All right, Grace, the Message Bible.
Oh, teach us to live well.
Teach us to live well.
Teach us to live wisely and well.
Teach us to live well. Teach us to live wisely. Powerful. ESV.
So teach us to number our days that we may get a heart of wisdom.
Teach us to number our days that we may get a heart of wisdom. Mr. Philip.
So teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom.
That we may gain a heart of wisdom. So any version?
Esther?
Mungu nifunze kunyamaza. Hakuna mtu akona Swahili version? Serious? Okay, Kikuyu version? Alright, so the Bible is basically saying, teach us to number our days. Alright? So lift up your Bible and say, this is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
I am what it says I am.
I am what it says I am.
I will be what it says I will be.
I will, be
I will go where it says I will go.
I will go
my mind is made up.
My
heart is made up. I will never be the same again.
In Jesus'
name. And God's good people say,
amen.
So teach us to number our days that we may apply or we may have or we may live wisely, according to several translations that we have read. So basically, the first thing that we discover there, people of God, is that your days are numbered. Your days are numbered, right?
Yes.
Your days are numbered. In other words, you cannot have the same number of longevity, like the way you are, compared to a young person or a baby that has been born today. They may outlive you. Chances are they may outlive you. Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
If you're 50, they might outlive you. If you're 20s, maybe muneza pelekana. But basically what the Bible is telling us, that your days are numbered. The part of your life that is not numbered is your eternal life. But your earthly life is numbered. So every single minute, every single hour, every single week, you are actually fulfilling your destiny. Destiny is not a destination. When I talk about destiny, it's the purposes of God concerning your life and their fulfillment. I'm not talking about the Bujubanton song. Destiny, not that one. I mean the purposes of God concerning your life and their fulfillment. Can I hear a better amen? But then in this church we laugh and we enjoy and we relax.
Yes, we do.
Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
So, yes. And we ask questions. If you have a question, you ask. All right? So, God has placed you on this earth to fulfill an assignment. Me, as your pastor, I'm fulfilling my assignment by teaching you the word of God. Somebody here has been called to the world of business. Another one to the world of career. So, every time you're dilly-dallying, you're doing what? You're wasting time. So, there is nothing like killing time. You're actually killing yourself. Because you are the sum total of time. Nikuje pole pole leo. When you say you're 40 years, what is that? You're actually giving us the time you have lived on this earth. Alright? So in this 2021, ask God to teach you to be wise with your time. This psalm in Psalm 90 is not David that wrote it. It was written by Moses. And I'm going to get there. I'm going to tell you why he wrote that and why he said some certain things there. But basically, you should tell God to teach you to number your days wisely. If you allow God to teach you to number your days, you will not waste time with places you are not supposed to be. Can I hear better? Amen. In picture Jesus, he has 3.5 years to finish his assignment. Can you see him on Netflix? Are you seeing him binging?
He's not chilling.
Now, I'm not saying it's wrong to watch movies. I'm saying, where is your priority? So in 2021, where is your priority? What is this assignment that God has given you that you keep on postponing? You keep on postponing. You keep on postponing. Chances are you're running out of time. Can I hear better? Amen.
Amen.
Can I hear better? Amen.
Amen.
Can I hear better? Amen.
Amen.
Some of you now, you should ask God for a spouse, because you're getting to a place where you now have to go to your next level in your assignment, and you need a spouse to come into play. Some of you, you need to go back to school. What a spirit, son.
Amen.
Yes, you need to go back to school. In this time of life, God demands you to go back to school. So you could be asking God for capital, yet he gives you money for what? School fees. Eh, kuna mtu amekanyaga hapo. So teach us to number our days, that we may do what? We may gain a heart of wisdom. So wisdom is where? Numbering your days. Wisdom is in numbering your days. See, there will be times in 2021 that your friends will tell you, let's go to Malindi, and you tell them, no. My assignment is very important than Malindi. Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
Some of them are going to Malindi to fulfill their assignment. Oh, now I see the kiza. Watch out, you are a kanyage. I'm helping somebody here. All right? So, ukiamka asubuhi, ask God, where should I go? Should I go to town? Should I travel all around? What is this very thing that I'm supposed to do today? Rich people are maximizing on their 24 hours. They don't have extra hours. They don't have 42 hours. They have 24 hours like you and I. But they are maximizing on their time. Can I hear better? Amen. Can I hear better? Amen. If you're past 25 years, okay, if you're past 20 years, you cannot be sleeping like a what? Like a snake. You are hibernating. You're sleeping for 20 hours, man. You're sleeping on your destiny. You're sleeping on your assignment. Can I hear better? Amen.
Amen.
Hey, it's getting quiet. Okay, let's go to the next point. So you need wisdom. Tell yourself, I need wisdom. And you remember we looked at 4 things that Christ has been made unto us,
yes.
And we looked at wisdom.
Yes.
So wisdom is in you.
Yeah.
You only need to activate it. You only need to ask God, where should I go? He says he will direct your steps.
Yes.
So in January, Uliza God, where should I go? Can I hear better? Amen.
Amen.
All right, let's look at Ephesians 5 and verse number 15. It says, see then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. Redeeming what?
Time.
Meaning, to redeem, I said what last Sunday, is buying back.
Yeah.
So you should walk circumspectly. You should walk prudently. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Are we stuck? You need what? Ephesians 5, 15 to 16.
Okay.
See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. And that is why in the Old Testament, all right, Prophet Joel says that God will restore wasted time. So if you wasted time in 2020, may God help you redeem time in Jesus' mighty name. And you know, there are things that waste your time, funny relationships. Eh, ukona boyfriend ajay commit. You have been dating for 9 years. you're married by proxy. Eh, ukimuliza tu, are we going? Usipeleke mse mbio. 9 years. That's a kaka worm. It's eating in your time. Can I hear better? Amen. Refuse for people to waste your time.
Yes.
Can I hear better amen?
Amen.
Don't allow people to waste your time. Redeem the time, for the days are evil. So if you wasted time in 2019, God can redeem time for you. And God is so merciful. God can speed you up. And I pray for that grace to speed you up.
Amen.
That's why we are now in the season of supernatural. So things will happen supernaturally.
Amen.
So don't waste supernatural events. Hey, that's powerful.
Amen.
Don't waste what? Supernatural events. Okay? Be so alert. Be so discerning in Jesus' name. Colossians 4:5 says, walk in wisdom towards them that are without, redeeming the time. So in both passages, redeeming time is related to wisdom in how we walk and how we live. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Say with me, time is a gift.
Time is a gift.
Time is a gift from God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm reminded of Psalm 139 from verse 16. The Bible says, David speaking, you see my substance being yet unformed, and your book, they were all written, the days fashioned for me, when as yet there was none of me. In other words, before I was born, God had written from the first day to the last day what I'm supposed to do. Psalm 139, verse 16. So like I was telling some people yesterday in my house, some people have used 50% of their days. Some people are now aging to 90%. Kuna mwingine ako 24%. And the saddest reality is, nobody knows the percentage we have. Sidio, you can tell how much charge is remaining on your phone, but you can't tell how much time that is remaining in your life. I pray you will not die prematurely. You will enjoy life and everything, but there's no point of having 936 years like Methuselah, and there's nothing to show for. The only thing that we can reference you ni umezeeka. May that not be your portion in Jesus' name. And I hear better amen. So, the days have been numbered. Now let's go to this psalm. I told you the psalm is written by who?
Moses.
By Moses. So he says, teach us to number our days that we may have apply a heart of wisdom. Okay, Turudi Nyuma. Turudi, verse number 10. Grace, Jio kusoma yo. Verse number 10. Psalm 19. Verse number 10. Bible ya grace imeshia 89. Okay. Nani yata some? Yes, yes. Faith. Yes.
The days of our lives are 70.
Verse 11.
Who knows the power of your
arm? The days of our lives are 70 years. Okay. Verse 11. Continue. And if by reason of strength, they are 80 years.
Wow.
Yet their boast is only labor and sorrow. Read the NIV, please. We hear.
NIV.
Uh-huh.
The length of our days is 70 years.
Uh-huh.
Or 80. If we have the strength.
If we have the strength.
Yet their span is but trouble and sorrow.
Mm-hmm.
For they quickly pass and we fly away.
Wow. So when Moses was writing this, the revelation he had is that you can only live 70 years. Kienda sana 80 years. This is in the Old Testament, in the Old Covenant. In the New Covenant, we choose when to die. We will revisit that. Shall we somewhere? We shall revisit in Jesus' name. So in the New Covenant, God can tell you, sadly, you only have 5 hours to live. Set your things in order. You can contest it. You can tell God, remember this, remember that, like Hezekiah. You remember him?
Yes.
And God can allow you by providence to give you more years. But let's remain in the context of what? 70 and 80 years. All right. So Glenn, how old are you? 27. All right. So 80 minus 27? Eh? 53. I'm doing mathematics. 53. Okay, normally, let's take a normal day. You will learn how many hours?
8 hours.
So 8 minus 24? 16. Cindy?
Yes.
8 minus 24 is 16.
Yes.
All right. You shower approximately 5 minutes. I do not have any. Oh, remain in church, man. Okay. Kuchana hata na kushawa. Kukula, breko, lunch, na supper, na kuenda job. Kuzipe how many hours?
Job ni 8 hours.
Job ni 8 hours, so mebaki na 8 hours. Sindio, kwa 24 mebaki na 8 hours.
Yes.
Kwa hiyo, 8 hours toa kukula. The 2, the 3, whatever. Then toa shower. Toa kuenda loo. Toa Facebook time. Hizo zote. You will be surprised if you are back in a 1 hour. So in other words, it is you are actually achieving your goals in your 1 hour. So you're actually squandering like 23 hours every single day. May God help us, because some of us are on social media for 3 hours.
It's getting cold. Let's continue.
So teach us to number our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. I did not come to bash you. I came to tell you how to have a great year. This is how you have a great
year.
Bonus fue sana. All right, so how do you have a great year? Number one, give yourself holy. Give yourself holy. Give yourself holy. Let me begin by telling us and telling me myself that we have to give ourselves holy. See, there are people that are married, but they have not given themselves to their spouses. Eh? Like one pastor who made me laugh. Hey, he made me laugh so hard. He said, me, I can't give my wife my heart. My heart belongs to Jesus. I give her my liver. He laughed. You're getting it. So like that man of God, he has given his wife what? Half his ajampero yake. Can I hear an amen? So if you're going to have a great year, give yourself holy, number one, to God. You must give yourself holy to God. You cannot be a part-time Christian. You cannot be praying when things are haywire. You cannot be coming to church when kinomana. That is using God. God is not a spare tire. Can I hear an amen? You must give yourself holy. You must love God when you have money and when you don't have money. You must be committed to God whether there is money or not. You must be committed to the cause of God whether you're single or married. Give yourself holy to God. Can I hear a better amen?
Amen.
Can I hear a better amen?
Amen?
Good to see you, madam. Please come forward. There's a seat here in Jesus' name. So give yourself holy. In 2021, increase your commitment. Increase your commitment. Be committed to God. Be committed to reading your Bible. You will not die because you're fasting. Hallelujah. Let me stay to this other church here. You will not die because you're fasting. Eh? What
yes.
You may not fast. You may not die.
I fast.
Hey.
Fast.
What are you going to fast? You will not die because you're fasting. Listen, can I teach you something on fasting?
Yes.
Can I demystify some few things here?
Yeah.
When you fast, you're not. It's not your fasting that gives you things from God. Okay, sorry. Sorry, Kanoa. Ni sawa tu. Kuna hiyo. Eh? Ati? Eh, deception, notion. Ata nisitani ufala. People think that God will give me something because I'm fasting. That's a lie.
That's a lie.
God has given you everything in Christ Jesus.
Wow.
So if you're fasting to get something, then you're doing what? You're actually working to get it. And your works will never get you something.
Amen.
So why do we fast, Pastor? I fast so that I can hear God.
Amen.
When you're eating too much, when you're so much into this world, chances are you're not hearing God. Dish, DSTV, when you're showing a DSTV. Ukigusa DS to kidogo, the signal inapotea. Sindio? Kidogo tu na some few degrees. inapotea. So your spiritual ear is always supposed to be inclined for voice of God. But there are so many voices that are already speaking in your life. There's a voice that is telling you 2021 out to make. Kumbuka 2020. That's already a voice that is speaking. There's a voice of your landlord telling you, I'm coming today with 4 padlocks. Mezoya tatu so they upgrade. There's the voice of your children. There's the voice of your wife. Can I hear an amen? So I fast so that I can be sensitive to the voice of God. Not so that God can give me a car, a house, or money. Mm-mm. If fasting was to give you property, hey, Africans, in fact, Kenyans will be very rich. Fasting will never give you a car. Fasting makes you sensitive to God. Can I hear better? Amen.
Amen.
Now, let me show you another rider. This will bless you, man.
Yes.
Fasting does what? Makes me sensitive to the voice of God. Now, prayer, Glenn. Prayer does this. Pastor has said, it's your year of supernatural ownership.
Yes.
All right. Now, when I begin to pray today, 3rd of January, and I continue to pray, what prayer does, prayer aligns things to make it supernatural. So, I repeat.
Yes.
Fasting makes us sensitive to God. Prayer, we may receive the word. Because at last year, to you appear word, I was coming, I was telling you, I feel God is telling you to do this. Okay? Now, when I go to my closet and pray, prayer begins to align things so that I see the supernatural. So, in June, kuna mtu haujui, haujamuona, but anafa kuingia kwa plani yako. So, the moment nina pray, God anaanza kumleta kwa njia yako. So, muna kudana. That's why when you don't pray, the guy doesn't come. He doesn't come. And then you are there complaining God that he's a house. No. God gave you the word. And God said, pray. When you begin to pray, things begin to align. You guys are not here by mistake. I pray, I tell God, wasumbuye, make them lack sleep. I want them in church. You have given them me a word, so. And that, I go on Galile and you may have to put your church. Steamer in a potato, token Zilaisha, DSTV in a kako, pastor prayed. Can I hear better? Amen. So, when you stop praying, the supernatural becomes natural. That's why I tell you, come at 10, we pray for 30 minutes. I know what I'm doing in your life. Now you know why you should be coming early to pray. Can I hear an amen? So, fasting and prayer, that's why Jesus has said, this one cannot be cast out except when you fast and pray. So, when you fast, you will be sensitive. God will tell you, this is how you should pray. Because you're praying amiss. You're not hearing God. You're binding where you're supposed to be losing. And there are prayers that God doesn't answer. Oh, Father, make me holy. God doesn't answer that. He made you holy in Christ.
Amen.
Father, I want to know more of you. No, you grow in knowledge. Father, give me the knowledge of Christ.
Amen.
Can I hear an amen? Amen? So you put your plate aside to be sensitive. Now, as you're sensitive and you're praying, God will direct you.
Amen.
Uko na plan ya kwenda shule, God akwambie apana, open this business.
Wow.
And then people are wondering, how are you making it? You're combining two principles.
Wow.
So give yourself wholly to God. Now, there are three things that you need to understand. You must read the word so that you can pray, so that you can be sensitive. You have to read the word of God. The word of God is the fire, the ember, that will help you pray. And while you're praying, now you can be sensitive to the voice of God. Awezi pray na una word. Ukikuwa una pray na una word, ni moto na ina kuni. So ni moto inawaka, lakini hakuna kuni. So with time, hiyo moto itafanya nini? Itaisha. That is why unapataga any time. time you're reading the Bible, you're fired up to pray. You're fired up. Like today, you came for a recharge. Tukienda home kwenye usaizi afternoon, mutakuwa ownership. Wednesday, ownership. Can I hear better amen? Every time you come to church, Ken, and I give you scriptures, those are words from God that you should use the whole week until the next recharge. So what happens when you miss church? You stay with the old recharge until inaisha. One has few sons. So give yourself wholly to what? To the word of to God, to the word of God, to prayer and to fasting. Someone read for us Ecclesiastes 12. 12, verse number 1. Ecclesiastes 12 and verse number 1. Give me a microphone, please. Who will read? Yes. Thank you, Glenn. Ecclesiastes, who is going to read verse number 1? One, two, go.
Remember also your Creator in the days of your youth.
Hold on. We'll go slowly. Glenn was a catch. Remember?
Also your Creator.
In the?
Days of your youth.
Okay. Continue.
Before the evil days come and the years draw near, of which you will say, I have no pleasure in them.
Hold on, son. So the Bible tells us to remember God where?
In the days of our youth.
Because there are days that are coming that we will not have pleasure in doing them. Listen to me, people of God. You have your parents. They are older. See you? You will hardly see your parents winning souls. They are old. You will hardly see them praying in the spirit much more fervently like you. They are old. See you? So the Bible is saying, while you have the energy, remember God. That's what the Bible is telling you. While you have the energy, win souls. While you have the energy, preach the gospel. While you have the energy, pray, man.
Amen.
Pray, man. Pray.
Amen.
Pray, because you're building a bank.
Amen.
When you're 80 years old, you will need those prayers. That's what the Bible says. Continue.
Before the sun and the light and the moon and the stars are darkened and the clouds return after the rain. In the day when the keepers of the house tremble and the strong men are bent and the grinders cease because they are few. And those who look through the windows are dimmed and the doors on the street are shut. When the sound of the grinding is low and one rises up at the sound of a bird and all the daughters of song are brought low.
Listen, let me read the Message Bible for you. Verse number 3. I'ma watch how you begin from verse number 1. Honor and enjoy your Creator while you're still young, before the years take their toll and your vigor wanes. You will not always be that beautiful. Okay, sorry. You will be beautiful, graciously, but you're getting old. Even if you age like fine wine, Buddha boss, utakaa hivi. Kubali tukatae. Hata ukiwekelewa mti zipigo hivi. Bado utalala hivi. Atukatae. You will still be beautiful in your husband's eyes. But the fact remains, utakuwa? Me, I usually pray for myself. Hata nikizeeka, nisipoteze nywele. In Jesus' name, alright? So the Bible is saying, before your vision dims, and the world blurs, and the winter years keep you close to the fire, in old age, your body no longer serves you as well. Muscles slacken. Muscles do what? Size you kona figure 8. Size you kona figure 16. Grips weakens. Joints stiffen. And so on and so forth. Remember God. Right now, go to see Carol. Right now that you're able to come to church, come to church. A day will come, you will not be able. Zile say us, okay, tutakuwa na place yetu. But I think to take a lift. But rather to take a lift, unaweza hang. Shuka lift wa jibu zana, niku wanaenda wapi, urudi tena, chini, waende home. Ukifika home, unasikia text imeingia, the service was powerful, I didn't even attend. Sunday, can I hear the amen? Serve God while you have the strength.
Amen.
Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
Men, pray for your family members when you have the strength. Born as if you are a son. Remember God. I pray you remember God. I love what Apostle Paul tells his son Timothy in 1 Timothy 4:6. Let me read so that you can be able to go a little bit faster. 1 Timothy chapter number 4 from verse number 6. 12, we shall read somewhere there. We shall read it also. Yeah. So verse number 6. If you instruct the brethren in these things, you will be a good minister of Jesus Christ, nourished in the words of faith and of the good doctrine which you have carefully followed. So what is he's told? If you instruct the saints in these things, which things? From verse number 1 to verse number 5. You can go and read. It says now, the Spirit expressly says that in the latter times some will depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of demons, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their consciousness seared with hot iron, and so on and so forth. So, Anandiwa, let's continue from verse number 7. But reject profane and all wise fables, and exercise yourself rather unto godliness. For godly exercise profited a little, but godliness is profitable for all things. Okay? So he's giving his protege instructions to give himself holy. Okay? To end there, let's go to verse number 12. Let no one despise your youth, but be an example to the believers in word, in conduct, in love, in speech. Hold on. Let no one despise your youth. So why would people despise that you are young? Because they are looking at your example. So, unasikia mtu amesema, huyo ni utoi na msumbua. It's your conduct they are looking at. So, unaona? Be an example to believers in what? In word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, in purity. Till I come, give attention to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. These are instructions he's giving him. Do not neglect the gift that is in you, which was given to you by prophecy, with the laying on of the hands by the eldership. And then he tells him, meditate on these instructions that I'm giving you. Give yourself entirely to them, and your progress will be evident to all. Give yourself to God, and the evidence will appear to all. You cannot be near God, be near the things of God, and remain the same. You can't. One of the qualities I look at the friends I keep, are you on fire for God? Me, I love people that are on fire for God. Akakamu unashirabu. Man, we are good friends. You're on fire for God. That's the person I want. Oh, glory. How? Watch our nyonge, watch your fire. Because fire ignites another fire. I don't love lukewarm people. Because I'll begin doing some crazy stuff. I like having fiery people. Amen. Bro, I have a crazy friend. Yeah? And then bro. Unajua leo nitoka ku pray na kumbia, bro, unajua. Nilikuwa tu kwa presence ya God. Nimetoka mlimani. Afu najua sivagi mlima, mlimani. Nitoka ku kusujudu. Ati, nilikuwa kwa closet manzi. For seven hours. Kwa bro, yenye hiyo ni kriskali kabisa. So, tukiachana, I am pushing my lips. I have to pray, man. You get it? We are not competing. Anani sharpen. Iron sharpens iron. You get it? So the next time tukipatana na mwambia, bro, I'm taking a 40-day fast. Hey, bro, Buddha, 40 days. Those are the kind of friends I want. In 2021, keep such friends.
Amen.
Don't keep friends that are making you backslide. Okay? Until you come to church, you are wondering, am I born again or born againest?
Sliding
with your back. So give, say, I will give myself holy. Manze, imwaka, tafadhali tu, soma judges, iishe. Soma tu, maliza judges. Obadiah, soma Obadiah, iishe. Please, inakuaga. Trust me, iko, iko. Can I hear an amen? Na ukishindo sana, soma kitabu inaitwa Philemon, ama Philemon. It's one chapter. Ama Jude, one chapter. Buddha. Angalau hata pasi ya kikuotu kitu unasema, hey, in Jesus, hey, najua kuna Jesus mahali hapo. Yes, I know, I know. Ama aje, sini ukweli? How can you be scrolling on Facebook, you're reading crap? Na Zephaniah, hata ujui iko hapi. Eh? Karibu siku moja ukuotu, the book of Hezekiah. No, Heze, where? Read your Bible, man. Give yourself to reading the Bible. Can I hear better? Amen. Do you know you will not die because you are praying for 1 hour? Do you know Jesus said you could not tarry for 1 hour? 1 hour. So the bare minimum came every day is 1 hour. Can I hear better? Amen. And in the group, I will be giving you prayer points because some of us don't have prayer points. I can give you prayer points on how to pray. Can I hear better? Amen. By the grace of God, and I say this to the glory of God, I am able to pray in tongues for 6 hours, non-stop. And then I take 1 hour to pray in the understanding.
7 hours.
So that's a basic 7 hour prayer. I didn't begin that way.
Yeah.
Nilikuwa naenda prayer, fam, mwenzei wanaomba bana. Hii, wana watu wanaomba. Unaomba, ukifika 10 minutes, unasema amen. Hallelujah. I receive it. That prayer, I'm saying mwingine. Oh, I shall be that. In Jesus' name. You have a sema. So I like sema, I shall be married. You must say amen. Now you're married. Eh? Can I hear an amen? But what did I do? The way you flex your physical muscles is the way you flex your spiritual muscles. Can I hear an amen? So give yourself wholly to God. Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
Then if you're married, give yourself to your spouse.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you're married, do what?
Give yourself
to your spouse. Give yourself to your family. Give yourself to your business. Manze usiendage lunch hour na saizo ndio clients wanakaa. Mimi ni upu. Nasaidia mtu hapa. Ati umechelewa, unafutwa kwa nini? Ati ulienda lunch hour. Kwa nini? Nilikuwa na professor. Kwa nini? Basi alisema. Man, be wise. Kama umeandiko job, masa ya kazi miaka, you'll be fired and you are a new creation. Going to heaven. You'll be fired though. You will be fired. Alafu mkuje hapa Sunday unatuambia, Mungu najua utanisahau. Bwana hajakusahau. Ni mfala ilikuchuja job. Please.
Amen.
Give yourself wholly to that job. You ask God for that job. You cannot be getting late to that job. Kama mnaingia saa mbili, ingia 7:50.
Yes.
Hey, I'm helping somebody here.
Yes.
Na hakuna kuhepa, ati unaenda maximum hapo town, tani. Wewe, be faithful in another man's vision. That is the way God will give you your own. I'm preaching good.
Yes.
Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
Give yourself holy. And then the second thing, exercise yourself. Exercise yourself. We are looking at how to have a great year. Go to see. Can I hear an amen?
Yeah.
So give yourself holy. The second thing, exercise yourself. See, because so many people ate in December. Medarigo, Mutura, Apa, Kule. You're getting my point? So right now, you have extra FAT. You're no longer PHAT. I'm that deep, man. Yeah. All right. So chances are you're going to enroll to a gym near you. So what are you doing? You're exercising your body. All right. Now listen to where we read. Up to 1 Timothy. Let's go back to 1 Timothy 4. 1 Timothy 4. What does the Bible say? It says, verse number 7, but reject profane and all wives' fable and exercise yourself towards godliness. In other words, the root word translated there means train yourself.
Yeah.
So he's saying, train yourself towards godliness. And then he gives you a contrast. Verse 8, for bodily exercise profits a little. There is some profit to get a gym, but nikidogo. It cannot be compared to your spiritual exercise. So for bodily exercise, profited a little. But godliness is profitable for all things. The way you train your biceps and triceps, God expects you this year to train your inner man. So beat your body to wake up and pray. Beat your body to fast. Train yourself. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
This year, please, train yourself to think some nice things, brother. Please.
Amen.
Please. What's on a COVID-19 pro? Think good stuff. Can I hear a better amen?
Amen?
Train yourself to talk nicely to people. Please. For once in your life,
you won't die.
You won't die. Train yourself to say thank you. Some of us, guys, say thank you, Nishida. Thank you. Ati niambie makanga, thank you. He's a human being. Jesus died for them. Yes. Tell them thank you. I appreciate. Najua I'm not a very nice rapper and a landlord, but ukilipa rent hii mwezi, mwambie thank you for your services. Just tell them thank you for your services. Train yourself. Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
Train yourself to think excellently. Walk excellently. Can I hear an amen? Have a mind laundry. Bona sifiwe sana. Say, I will train myself. Train your spirit, man. Listen, Wambo. I know you don't love reading. You love listening. But you can train yourself to read.
That's true.
Yeah. You won't die by reading one book. Hata kama utaanza chapter moja umalize December. Watch a mwaka isho useme, at least I read a book. Train yourself. I'm coming to you. Train yourself. Can I hear an amen? 1 Corinthians 9:27, Apostle Paul anasema, but I keep my body and bring it under subjection, lest by any means, when I preach to others, I myself should be cast out. I tell my body what to do. Me. 1 Corinthians 9:27. Me. I'm the one that tells my body what to do. I am the one that tells my body what to do. The Amplified says, I box my body. I box my body. I tell it what to do. Okay? 1 Corinthians 9:27.
Now I beat my body.
Soma Ken Yako.
Now I beat my body.
I beat my body.
And make it my slave so that.
Listen to that. I beat my body. I make it my slave. It doesn't tell me what to do. I tell it what to do. Can I hear an amen?
Yeah.
So you can tell your body to wake up at 3. By the way, watch any was idea. Akunaga masaya yote ati. Ati you have to pray specifically at 3. That's where the angelic things are happening. Dio Shaito ametoka Honolulu, Hawaii. Nalayo ati vita zanga. Apana. Apana. You pray anytime. Where went you to after time? As long as you pray. The point is you must pray. Okay? So for me and yes, si chomi ni ukweli, mi usiku, mi na practice, he gives sleep to the beloved. So mi usiku, mi na lala po. Lakini mchana junior assignment yango, I will pray. So most of the morning times, uneza nikuta nikiwa offline, I'm praying. Occasionally, as the Spirit of God leads me, I can wake up at 3 and pray. But me, I love my sleep. But that doesn't mean I don't pray. So Ken, come away, uneza pray usiku, mchana uko busy, get time to pray.
Amen.
That's the point.
Amen.
So Apostle Paul says, I beat my body. Now, write this in your hearts, not your notebook, in your hearts. No matter who backslides, remain focused. Even if your pastor backslides, you remain focused. That is what you tell your body. Can I hear an amen? No matter who stops coming to church, keep coming. You train yourself. No matter who stops giving, keep giving. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
No matter what, who stays disloyal to Christ, you stay loyal. Buddha boss, one of these fine days, utasimama mbele ya unamtaje saji God na utamwambia you need to come out of this. We call it a hard mentality. Ushaona mangombe ama mambuzi. I have seen where we were in Nakuru, there was a place kulikuwa na railway station. Alafu mbuzi zikuwa zinapenda kupita hapo. So, zilikuwa zinafika wakati train inapita. Alafu mazia zina sense of knowing. Moja inapita zinafuatana, zinaenda zikisiago tu. It's called a herd mentality. Hakuna yenye inaambia mwingine hii ni kifo. Wote wanapita hapo wanasiago. And in church, we also have a herd mentality. Unaenda na crowd. But then you are shocked. Can I shock you? God is never in the crowd. God is never in the crowd. God is never in the spectacular. So just because, listen, these things delivered me. Just because a pastor has 10,000 members doesn't mean God is there. So I can kill myself to change the doctrine that God gave me so that I can have 10,000 members. Pressure, that's a hard mentality. Don't have a hard mentality. Listen, can I help you? The fact that somebody is failing does not mean you're failing. Man, the fact that you don't have money in your account doesn't mean you're lazy. That's powerful, man. I'm delivering somebody here. The fact that you didn't do a nice wedding doesn't mean you're ending in divorce. You're going to come there in Jesus' name. So you personally, Sally and the rest of us, know that you're in a race. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
For your first Corinthians 9:27. Ebu turudi verse 24. Wacha niwasome Amplified. Amplified inasema, do you not know that in a race all the runners compete, but only one receives the prize? So run your race. Let us run all of us. He's saying, run your personal race that you may lay hold of the prize and make it yours. Now everyone, verse 25, now everyone, every athlete who goes into training conducts himself temperately and restricts himself in all things. Who is restricting? You. So you are telling yourself. That is why there are certain relationships, ziishe tuna disemba, ziishe. You restrict yourself. That's what he's saying. You are an athlete. Buda ukienda Eltoret. Ukute Kipchoge uko. Wanaongea na Mayweather. Umse anaitwa na yule, he's a boxing guy.
Yes.
Something is wrong.
Sindio?
Mayweather amekuja Eldoret. Afai kuwa uko. Something is wrong. So, Kipchoge has to restrict his circle and choose who is coming to his circle. Some of you uliacha ku follow plan ya God jiwa mabeste ulileta. Wakakuambia wewe ukusikia Mungu. Wewe ukusikia Mungu. Let me shock you. When I was in fair, tell your neighbor when I was in fair. Hallelujah. When I was in fair.
Yes.
So, there is a very nice church, a beautiful church, prophetic church. But you know the way you can be in a church, na kuna kuwana two prophets, tuko huko machini, ma underwater. So me, I went excited. I told them, man, this is now my wife, then my fiance then to be. I took wife, young, sasa kids. And then this is the woman God has. I felt the impression when you're not man. Man, one of the prophets,
the prophet.
I don't know whether aliqua the far you see or the side you see. Maybe you didn't hear God. Buddha, you didn't hear God. You need to go and pray. Man, nimeenda kwa closet nimeomba. Hakuna kitu nasikia. Nimeingia confusion. Buddha, mimi nimekuta wife nikamwambia, hebu tuombe. Now, factor in, had I stepped away, I would not be married to the beautiful woman she is to me.
Amen.
I would not even be a pastor. Ningekuwa maybe nauza keg. Na pump tu pale. Juu niko frustrated, niliachana na God. Na pump tu.
Na kibao.
Na kibao. Imagine. And this is why, when I prophesy over your life, I usually tell you, go ask God whether I say the truth. That's how you test a spirit. Can I hear a better amen?
Amen?
So, there are certain people you bring in your cycle, and that is the end of you. May that not be your portion in 2021. We unajua ni nani? Unajua ni nani mwenye anakujaga na kuweka nje? Decide, manze kwanza, piga yeye out.
mublock social platform zote. By the way, it is. Can I help you?
Yes.
Hey, Mr. Philip, umenyamaza leo. Ama ina so. Can I help you?
Yes.
It is scriptural to unfriend people on Facebook. It is scriptural to unfriend some people. Actually, kama profile page yako ya Facebook, I glorify God. Ifunge. Funga, fungua mpya. Add Bishop T.D. Jakes, Bishop Alan Kina. Add. By the way, hiyo ni mind laundry. Inakusaidia. Unajua Facebook page zingine zetu. Wewe uniangalie ze. Una scroll hivi ni Pastor Bob. Four things that Christ has been made unto us. Pastor Andrew, your marriage will start. Bishop Alan Kuna, decade of the miraculous. Uki scroll hivi. Ah, sehemu nyeti, zinafanya hivi. Ume backslide. Ulikuwa spiritual merudi nyama. Mimi hizi vitu ninaambia, go practice them. Listen, when the devil wants to trap you, he traps you with a thought. A thought to you. And some of these thoughts, because in a talk here for movie, that's why some movies don't watch. Beat your body. Beat your body. I don't mean there are no movies. There are Christian movies that are very nice. But as a believer, what are you doing watching a movie that has a gay theme? Na wewe ni jamaa, alafu unawanda kwa nini siku hizi unatembea hivi. You're wondering, koni unatumia lip balm? Lip balm, man. Lip balm. You're wondering. They say, Masharia, you become what you eat. You're becoming what you're watching. Sasa unakuja chat, unatupatia kazi ya deliverance. Toka! Tokeni! Nani wewe uliwaingiza? That's a fact. Are you getting blessed? Am I delivering somebody here? Watch what you're feeding, man. Watch what you're feeding. Watch. I keep myself. Mi ukiangalia Facebook page yangu, hata profile, WhatsApp profile yangu, it's for ministry. For some of you, it's for business. Do business there. Sisemi sasa uweke picha za Bible, NIV, NKJV, Message Bible, apana. But, swali yangu yenye najiulizaga ni, Yesu akichukua phone yangu, nitaanza kumwambia nini?
Singia hapo.
Nisingia hapo? Ati Yesu siingia hapo. Yesu usijaribu. Usijaribu. Password uli change na nimesahau. Oh God. May God have mercy on us in Jesus' name. Do you know Christ is looking at your private chats? He's looking. Ati it's what? They say what? It's just harmless flirting. There's nothing harmless. Sazile utageuka kuwe strange woman, utajua it was not. It was not. Watch out. Beat yourself. This is how you'll have a great year. I can show you how a woman can end up pregnant by a married man via a text message. You entertained us. Your text to Gambo, hi, you're looking beautiful. And because women are impressionable, I'm a notice. Shaito naenda naambia wasee, kujeni, kuna maja hapa. That's how people fall down. Tunafika December, now we have a baby dedication service.
Oh.
And you did not get married.
Wow.
Bwana asifiwe sana. Hebrews 12, verse number 1. The Message Bible. Do you see what this means? All these pioneers who blazed the way, all these veterans cheering us on, it means we'll better get on with it. Strip down, start running, and never quit. No extra spiritual fat. You have never seen Kipchoge in a trench coat. No, ma. Na mabuti zile za kwenda Mount Kenya. Ati ana train, hivi. That athlete, iko shida. Lazima abaki na something that will not be moved. Yes. Are you getting myself? So, remove spiritual fat. Spiritual fat. Remove extra weight. Toa bitterness. Toa offense. So that you can be able to run. It's not like you're not running.
but you uko na baggage, man, and you're running, so una choka. So ukifika January 31st, umechoka. You can't hear God, you don't know where you are. So unaambia pasi, pasi, tuko na get together home. Sunday sita come. May that not be your portion in Jesus' name. Amen. Number three, how to have a great year. Number three. 12, verse number 1 to 3, the message Bible. The third point, have a lifestyle of worship. Have a lifestyle of worship.
Amen.
Refuse to come to church to worship God on Sundays. Worship God on Monday morning, Tuesday afternoon. Worship God. Now, let me help you some here. Mko ready? Niwafunze kitu?
Yes.
I have said in this church, every time we have to learn things from the Old Testament, coming all the way to the New Testament. There is a difference in worship in the Old and in the New. Very different. You have an idea?
Yes.
You're ready to learn?
Yes.
In the Old Testament, we will do a teaching on praise and the New Testament, praise and worship, sometime in the year. But let me give you a precursor to it. So in the Old Testament, they would praise God for what? What he has done. So God ame to deliver. Kwa Red Sea. Martha. Miriam. Ame chukua darama. Ame we are grateful. God ame to pitisha Red Sea. Ame to talk for bondage. Hiyo ni praise. In the Old Testament. Siju, musi lose point in the Old Testament. Worship in the Old Testament, God, you are God. Nobody else is God. We have seen Mungu wa Nebuchadnezzar. Tumeona Mungu wa huyu. Lakini wewe tu ndio unastand kama God. Tumelewana hivyo? Now, in the New Testament, praise and worship may change. We praise God for what Jesus has done. We worship God for what Jesus has done. When you get that understanding, you will worship God with you inside. So, in the New Testament where we are, we worship God for what Jesus has done. Okay? Now, worship, kuna two different types of worship. Can I help you?
Yes.
Am I?
Yes.
Ama tufunge tuende? Tunalan kitu. Two different types of worship in the New Testament. Worship yenye ina matter, na yenye kuna the miraculous. Nyenye una exalt Christ. But most of the time as believers, we worship who we are in Christ. We don't worship Christ. And there's nothing wrong with that. Ni vizuri kujijua wewe ni nani kwa Kristo. But the epitome of worship is exalting the Lamb of God. That is why the hymns are so powerful. Like, let me give you a song. Rejoice is about who you are in Christ. I'm gonna dance and praise him. It doesn't matter what comes my way. The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus. I'm born a winner. You see, all that song is about who you are in Christ. So it is exalting your position in Christ. But it's not exalting Christ per se. Now, a worship song that exalts Christ. Lamb of God, seated at the right hand of the Father, you are holy. Holy, you are holy. Now, let me take you back to last Sunday. Jesus said, concerning dominion in Shetani Elichukua, in Luke. Remember Luke 4, where we read? In the temptation, the devil said, if you bow down and worship me, all the kingdoms of this world, I will give them to you. And Jesus said, get thee behind me, Satan, for you shall worship your Lord God alone. So when I exalt Jesus, the deity that I've exalted has to fight for me, has to heal me, has to deliver me, has to empower me. Yes.
The reason altar za shetani na za wachawi na za ninizi na watu ni kwa nini? They worship that deity. It has to function. So what is the secret? Niko kwa shida. I will not say who I am in Christ. It is good. But I will exalt Christ himself. He has to come. In the Old Testament, they say, when praises go up, blessings come down. Now, praises are not going up in the New Testament. Praises are going inside of me. So, in the New Testament, I worship Jesus by looking at him. I behold him. I see him. I worship him. Man, he has to come and command things around. Can I hear an amen? So I don't worship God for who he is. I worship God for what he has done and who he is now. So, you oneshe? Mumeshika ama mepotea? Mumeshika. So mimi, in the morning, what I tell him, oh, thank you, Jesus, my best friend. Thank you for loving me. You are high and lifted up. You are exalted above the heavens. None can compare you. Thank you for your spirit in me. Thank you that now in your spirit I can have communion with you. Man, I begin to do that. Nanza kuona ready. Nanza kuona. I see what you're going through. I begin to pray for you. He opens my eyes to see every one of you. And I can take my phone. Most of you have texted. I text you and you are going through the same problem I'm telling you. Filio, that is what it happens to you. So which deity are you exalting? Which deity are you exalting? There are some people that are exalting money. There are people that are exalting their families. You exalt Christ. If I be lifted up, I will draw men to myself. And I have told the worship team here, God akitusaidia tutapata screen. We'll be singing more Christ, Christocentric worship songs and praise songs. And one or two in him songs. Can I hear an amen? You do that. Please. Easy, panana. You do that, you will walk in the miraculous. I don't need to lay hands on you. You will. Listen, Ken. Ebuski in song. I am the Lord that he led me. I am the Lord your healer. I send my word and heal your disease. I am the Lord your healer. Ni nini noma, Mr. Masharia, kama hiyo wimbo wakati nasikia kwenye msiku. It is showing you, me, I am your Lord, I come to heal. You're quoting the scripture, I send your word, and your word heals. You sing that song until healing becomes a reality, and then you manifest it. Si kuimba mateke, utapiru mateke. Nothing wrong with that. But there's a place where you worship God. Me, I tell you the truth. There are times I worship, I feel like I'm burning. Can I hear better? Amen. Get to levels, people of God, that you can kneel down. Man, just kneel down before God. Sa hizi uhunia katokea pale. Aseme, where? Unaenda utapiga magoti na hizo sauti zako za Kashmir utapiga magoti na Gucci na Dolce Gabbana utaenda, you will go prostrate and it's a mere human being. Tuli kweli, a bare human being that can't give you life, you will go low. What about the King of Kings that guaranteed that you will get to heaven? Mimi this floor, I will lie prostrate. Because I love him. I love him. Can I hear an amen? Man, sijui hii story ya Ukristo ati mwanaume ni chuma, uwezi lia. Kabla uone machozi ya mwanaume. Man, develop an attitude of crying before God. Si kulia ati juu kanyumba kamefungwa. Hapana, just
just imagine His majesty, His goodness, His grace. Man, this God parted the Red Sea. This God alizuia Daniel kutopuliwa na simba. This God alistrengthened Samson, akijua weaknesses zake. This God alipea Solomon wisdom, akijua huyu today ni noma. Yet haku withhold. Hawa sa wote wa Old Testament walikuwa na ngoja experience ya God kukuja juu yao ndio wafanye vitu. Wewe uko na yeye ndani. Hapa.
Thank you for loving me too much.
Man, develop an attitude of worship. Don't wait for grace and glad to lead you in praise and worship. Can I hear an amen? Uko na data bundles. Uko na YouTube. Wake up some nice songs. Eh? Pick a loop. Just worship. Just worship. Can I hear an amen? For a minute, just worship Him. Tell Him some nice names, some nice things. Tell Him, I love You. You're so beautiful in my life. Thank You. Thank You, Lord, for beautifying my life. Thank You for dying on the cross for me. Thank You for Your grace and glory. Thank You for beautifying my life. Thank You that now I am a new creation. Just worship Him. Lamb of God that took away reproach and shame from my life, from my eyes. I worship You in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So John 4:20 says, our Father worshipped in this mountain, and you say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. So in the Old Testament, you will only worship God in a synagogue. And then Jesus now tells us in verse number 21, Jesus said unto her, woman, believe me, the hour cometh when you shall neither in this mountain nor at Jerusalem worship the Father. In other words, you shall not be locked out on kukuja tu kwa synagogue. An hour is coming when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit. We are worshiping the Father where? In spirit, because we are spirit people. In truth, reality of Christ. Truth is a person. The person is Jesus. Okay? So we worship who? Jesus. For what He did for us. Can I hear better? Amen. How to have a great year. I close for today with be full of gratitude. Be full of gratitude. Be full of gratitude. Man, go home today and look at your journey. All those years that umeishi. Umbali umetoka. Na mahali unaenda. God alikulipia school fees ukiwa nasari. God alikulipia school fees ukiwa primary. God alikupea the first pair of shoes. Ilikuja na mzazi na ni God aliprovide. God ndio amekuprotect all these years. Ile siku ulibutiwa na huyo chali huyo. Ulienda kwa kunywa ratendra vizuri. Na ukaiweka mpaka tomato sauce. But huku David. God. Can I hear an amen? You lost your job. You almost lost your mind. But God. Can I hear an amen? If it had not been for the Lord, who was on your side, can I hear an amen? Can I hear better amen?
Amen.
Do you know how many people ulipitana nao last year na walikuwa na COVID na uliwasalimia na ikukushika? Do you know how many times ulishuka mat ikaenda mbele ikahijakiwa? Huh? Do you know how many times ulikuwa almost to be auctioned but God? But God. Do you know how many times you were bedridden? You took all the drugs you know of. The doctors were helpless. But God. Do you know how many times people wrote you off? Said all manner of stuff. But God. But God. Approach God with thanksgiving in your heart. If you are going to have a beautiful year, 2021, you must have an attitude of gratitude. You must tell Him, Father, I thank You. I blundered. I slept around. I stole. I did all manner of stuff. But You kept me. You forgave me. You did not land on me like a ton of bricks. You did not say, I don't want to be associated with You. But I came back like the prodigal son and You embraced me by Your love. I pray for you that in 2021, may you approach God with a heart of gratitude. Look at your life. Now you're married. You're married. In your family, nobody gets married. Now you're married. Now you have children, man. When you look at 2020 people of God, how are you able to pay house rent? We know you don't have a job, but how are you able to pay house rent? How? How? We know you don't have a job, but you're wearing some nice clothes. How? It has taken the hand of God. If we are going to see supernatural ownership, let's thank God for the rented properties. Man, God, I may not have a house, but umenipa rent. Oh, we thank you, mighty God. Umenipa uhai, Baba. Oh, let us, I want us to sing songs of gratitude, and then we are out of here. We worship you, Jesus.
Nashukuru Menipa uhai baba nafasi nyingine ya siku mpya baba
nashukuru